Hi, thanks for your interest in the Described and Captioned Media Program. In this video, I'll be demonstrating the DCMP iOS app. In order to use the DCMP app, you will need an iPhone, iPad, or iPod running on iOS 8 or later. You'll also need an internet connection fast enough to support streaming video. To find the DCMP app, I'll open the App Store, then click Search and type DCMP. Notice our familiar square blue logo in the search results. It should be the first result. Our app is free, so I'll simply click the Get button to install. I'm not prompted for a password here. You may be prompted for your password depending on your security settings. Once installed, I can click the Open button in the App Store or click the Home button and open the DCMP app from my home screen. Now I'll enter my DCMP username and password and click Sign In. If you don't have a DCMP account, you may click Continue as Guest to view the freely available videos we have in the collection. Once signed in, I'm able to browse, search, view my favorites, and change settings. I'll click Browse and select the topic Geography, the subject U.S. Geography, and the title Cowpens, A Battle Remembered. Now I'm at the title Details page, where I can view the captioned version, the described version, add to my favorites, read the full description, grade level, production year, and producer information. I'll choose the Stream Captioned English button, and we'll see the title start streaming. I'll rotate the device landscape to view it full screen.
The day dawned cold and quiet. I'll never forget just how still that morning was.
Once finished, click Done on the top left, and I'm back on the title details page. Now I'll click the menu button on the top right and click Home. I'll now search for a title. I'll click Search and enter Adaptations. Notice that the search auto-completes and displays a list of titles matching the search term immediately. I can click Search to see the entire list. I'll now click the Menu button and go back to the home screen. I'll select Favorites, which is the same favorites list I already used on DCMP.org. Here I'm able to click any title and jump to its title details page. I'll click the Back button and swipe left across a title to reveal the Delete button. This removes the title from my favorites across all platforms, including DCMP.org, the iOS app, and the Roku channel. I'll click the Menu button and select Home. Now we'll look at settings. I have a few options: Change PIN, Change User, Appearance, and Log Out. Change PIN is used when you have student accounts. More on that later in this video. I'll choose Appearance. This menu allows us to change the appearance of the app by selecting one of several available themes. I will choose the Deer theme, which changes the color palette to earth tones and changes the background image on the home screen. While themes are nice for personal aesthetic preference, we actually developed this feature with low vision individuals in mind. I'll go back to Settings and Appearance, then select High Contrast 1. We're creating several high contrast themes with the help of low vision clients. Feel free to suggest changes and we'll add additional themes based on feedback. I'll now click the menu and choose Log Out. As you may or may not know, DCMP offers student accounts, which are restricted DCMP accounts managed by a student's parent or teacher. Check out our other training videos on DCMP.org or our YouTube channel to watch the student account demonstration video if you'd like more information. I'll now show you how the DCMP app works if you have student accounts. I'll sign in as a fictitious teacher who has 25 student accounts. Once signed in, I'm now prompted to set a mobile PIN number. This PIN is used when switching between student accounts and is intended to be a faster alternative to the normal DCMP password while still remaining secure. I'll now choose a unique 4 to 5-digit PIN number and click Continue. I'm presented with a screen that allows me to choose to continue as myself or log in as one of my student accounts. This is useful when sharing devices in the classroom and allows you to log in as any one of your students without having to remember their credentials. I'll choose James Smith and enter my PIN to continue. Now I'm at the main screen of the DCMP app. I'll choose Browse. You'll notice as I navigate the topics and subjects that our student, James, only has access to one title, America's Gold. Student account permissions are managed by the teacher on DCMP.org, and I only granted James access to one title. I am able to grant student account access to any number of individual titles or topics and subjects. Now I'll click the Menu button on the top right, then click Switch Users. I'll choose Tim Thomas. Enter my PIN and choose Search. I'll search for adaptations, just as I did previously in the earlier example. Notice that Tim only has one result, where our previous example had quite a few. This is because I only granted him permission to view one particular Hummingbird title. Rather than cluttering Browse and Search with titles for which students do not have permission to view, the system only returns those they are able to watch. I'll now click the Menu button and choose Log Out. The DCMP iOS app was designed to be simple, yet very functional. We hope you find it useful in the course of educating your students. If you have any questions, feature requests, or suggestions, feel free to contact us at support@dcmp.org. Thanks for watching.